Before starting the career in strategic communication, define your purpose. Before you join into the detail of your strategic communication projects, you need to have a clear vision of your purpose. Why? What are you trying to achieve? Who are you trying to reach? Who do you want them to feel? Act. Your purpose will guide your decision and action throughout the communication process. From planning to evaluate, it will also help you align your communication efforts with your organization mission, values, and objective. It's another important factor in strategic communication. Know your audience. One of the most important skills in strategic communication is audience analysis. You need to understand who your target audience, what they want to know about from your style. You also need to segment your audience into different groups based on their characteristics, preference and behavior. This will help you to convey your message, channels and strategies to each group and increase your impact and relevance. You can use various tools, like you can use survey, interviews, focus group, social media, and you can get your result. This is the another element of your strategic communication part. It's another point, once you get your purpose, once you know about your audience, of course, then it's about like message. Craft your message. Once you have clear purpose and a deep knowledge of your audience, you can craft your message. Your message is the core of your strategic communication. It should be clear, concise, consistent, and compelling. It should also align with your purpose and your target audience. For this purpose, you can use various techniques to make your message more effective, such as storytelling, framing, emotions, persuasions, call to action. It's very, very important factor. You should also consider the tone, style, language of your message and how they fit your audience and channel. And now come to the fourth point. After purpose, after audience, after message, of course you need to deliver your message. So now this is the time. Choose your channel. Another key skills in strategic communication is channel selection. You need to choose the best channel to deliver your message to your audience. You have a wide range of options, such as website, blogs, social media, newsletter, podcast, videos, webinar, and each channel has advantage and disadvantage as well. But it all depends what kind of message you want to deliver. So now come to the fifth one point, implement your plan. After you have defined your purpose, analyzed your audience, crafted your message and choose your best channel, you need to implement your strategic communication plan. This involves execution, your communication activities, managing your resource, coordination your team, and monitoring your progress. You need to be flexible and adaptable to deal with any challenge or opportunities that may arise. You also need to communicate effectively with your stakeholders, such as clients, PA partners, colleagues and supervisor as well. It's very, very important. Implementation part is the key part of strategic communication. Now, it's like the final part of strategic communication. Evaluate your result. The final skill in strategic communication is evaluation. You need to measure the outcome and impact of your communication efforts and compare them with your objective, your main purpose. Why? Start from why and end from with result. You need to collect and analyze data such as feedback, engagement, reach, conversation and reputation, you need to use various tools and methods to evaluate your results, such as surveys, interviews, again focus group, social media, web analytical, media analytical. You also need to report your findings, inside recommendation to your stakeholder, and use them to improve your future communication plan. Thank you so much. Give your feedback. Allah Hafiz.